sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
The Bible provides ample additional material for mythic and mystical speculation. The prophet Ezekiel's visions in particular attracted much speculation, as did Isaiah's temple vision, chapter 6. Jacob's vision of the ladder to heaven is another text providing an example of a mystical experience. Moses' experience with the burning bush and his encounters with God on Mount Sinai are all evidence of mystical events in the Tanakh and form the origin of Jewish mystical beliefs. Jewish mystical traditions always appeal to an argument of authority based on antiquity. As a result, virtually all works pseudepigraphically claim or are ascribed ancient authorship. For example, Sefer Raziel HaMalek, an astro-magical text partly based on a magical manual of late antiquity, Sefer HaRazim, was, according to the Kabbalists, transmitted to Adam, after being evicted, by the angel Raziel. Another famous work, the Sefer Yetzirah, supposedly dates back to the patriarch Abraham. According to apocalyptic literature, esoteric knowledge, such as magic, divination, and astrology, was transmitted to humans in the mythic past by the two angels, Azza and Azazel. In other places, Azazel and Uzazel, who fell from heaven, see Genesis chapter 6 verse 4. This appeal to antiquity has also shaped modern theories of influence in reconstructing the history of Jewish mysticism. The oldest versions of the Jewish mysticism have been theorized to extend from Assyrian theology and mysticism. Dr. Simo Parpola, a researcher at the University of Helsinki, has made some suggestive findings on the matter, particularly concerning an analysis of the Sephirot. Noting the general similarity between the Sephirot of the Kabbalah and the Tree of Life of Assyria, he reconstructed what an Assyrian antecedent to the Sephiroth would look like. He matched the characteristics of En-Sof on the nodes of the Sephiroth to the gods of Assyria, and was able to even find textual parallels between these Assyrian gods and the characteristics of God. The Assyrians assigned specific numbers to their gods, similar to how the Sephiroth assigns numbers to its nodes. However, the Assyrians use a sexagesimal number system, whereas the Sephiroth is decimal. With the Assyrian numbers, additional layers of meaning and mystical relevance appear in the Sephiroth. Normally, floating above the Assyrian Tree of Life was the god Asser. This corresponds to En-Sof, which is also, via a series of transformations, derived from the Assyrian word Asser.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.